So for me as a doctor and a YouTuber, I wanted a place to be able to store all my medical knowledge, but also to be able to write down my YouTube ideas and scripts. And so Notion I found is probably one of the best pieces of note-taking software for that. And today I'm going to be summarizing Tiago's Building a Second Brain book, because it's a really good book, but I think that if you want to know the direct implementation of it, this video is going to be super duper helpful for you. We're going to use Notion because it's my favorite piece of note-taking software. And regardless of whether you're going to use Notion or not, this video is still going to be really helpful for understanding how the different bits of building a second brain fit together. Building a second brain can genuinely be life-changing, and we're going to be talking about the code method, which involves capturing, organizing, distilling, and expressing, and we're also going to be talking about Tiago Forte's para method. So let's just get straight into it. And let's start off with the first part of the code method. So the first part of the code method is to capture any piece of information that you've thought of. It can be a conversation that you've had with a friend, it can be a web article or a book you've read. You just want one place to be able to go to immediately be like, ah, I need to go here so I can capture the piece of information. I'm gonna go pretty fast in this video because it's a hybrid summary of a book plus Notion, but if you wanted Notion in more depth, I've actually got a whole Skillshare course on Notion for students and professionals. You can check that out in the description. So with capture, I think capturing you can usually do in a table, which is a really easy way to do it. And here I'm just gonna create a new database and we'll have it as my initial database. I'm just gonna call it Second Brain, nice and simple. Let's say that you wanted to capture a thought. Well, here, maybe I'll just put in an individual thought, right? And you can literally capture anything. So let's say that I'm capturing, let's go real meta and capture the ideas behind a second brain. So if you go into a page, then you can, you know, put whatever note you've got there and be like, a second brain is a neat concept. And I'm going to delete this tags bit. And here, just use this literally to capture any thought, right? You can capture a thought like the mitochondria is the powerhouse of the cell. And any single thought can go in there. So that's a very, very simple second brain concept. Of course, it seems like a lot to have just a sentence in there, right? So you could have individual pages. So for example, you could actually make this biology of a cell. You can create the mitochondria is the powerhouse of the cell as like a sub-sentence within that particular heading. Let's say that you want to capture even more information. Well, you can, you know, capture under a toggle list some stuff here, and then I'm going to just literally copy and paste some stuff from Wikipedia about mitochondria. And literally copy paste that there, and now it has been captured. So that's nice. One other part of capture as well is I use this thing called Readwise. And so what Readwise does is you can actually take Kindle highlights and even highlights from Instapaper and Twitter, and then it will sync it automatically to Notion like this. So let me just go to Readwise for you. And so here I have these immense book summaries, which are super duper useful. And if you go into it, for example, the YouTube formula, it'll sync all your highlights into there, which is really nice because you can just literally copy and paste it into your second brain as you need it. So I've got a discount affiliate link for Readwise. They're not technically sponsoring this video. I just really like that service, but it is an affiliate link. So I will earn some money from that, which is nice if you want to support the channel. One thing that Tiago Forte talks about with capture is you want to try to capture what resonates with you. You want to capture information that you feel something from that resonates with you as a person, that matters to you, because the thing is, there's so much information out there that if you're just capturing a full deluge of information, your second brain is just going to get messy and convoluted, and it's not going to be very nice. If you had to choose between capturing or not capturing, generally speaking, capture if you're not sure, but if it's like, ah, I'm not going to use this anyway, don't worry about it. The next step is to organize. And so the context of thinking about organization, well, in Notion, you have these things called selects and you can organize it like that. Generally speaking, the organization part actually goes into what's called para. So with para, the concept is that you have projects, areas, resources, and archive. Now, when you have something that you're thinking about in your second brain concept, usually you actually want to think about it in terms of actionability. So when you're thinking of something in a project, generally that's the most useful. For example, if I'm working on a biology project or something to do with medicine, I might be thinking, hey, like I need to categorize this all in one place. So here I'm going to edit this property and call it project. And then I'm just going to name this medicine as an example. And second brain as like digital knowledge or maybe even YouTube video about second brain, because that's actually the real concept behind it. And so here, medicine is actually not really correct because that's more of an area, you know. Biology of a cell is a concept within medicine, but medicine itself, like, you can't do medicine, if that makes sense. You can do a project related to medicine. So you can, for example, create a presentation. So I might be like, I'm gonna create a presentation for high school students or something. And then that way I can start to tie together ideas. And in Notion, you can actually sort those out by filtering and then filtering by the project. And you know, if you have more notes which are within their, like how the liver works or something, then you can collect your knowledge very quickly in there like that. You can collect your knowledge very, very quickly in there. And this is a very simple version of this. The next component of code is that you want to distill stuff. And so let's start off with something a bit more complex. So in this particular case, I want to talk about migraines and the treatment of them. So if I open up this page, now you can see on this right-hand side, I've got a whole up-to-date article talking about the treatment of migraine. Up-to-date is like the doctor's Wikipedia. And here I might even just literally copy and paste a summary of stuff, just so I can have it there. This is a lot of information still. I haven't really got it in some sort of actionable sense yet. So what I want to do is I might want to create a summary. I mean, we're going to create a summary of a summary and say, title, this is a literature note. And here and above, create the summary. If I open this as a page, but also create a new window, which is going to be the exact same page, then this way I can look at the note and then hope to summarize individual bits. For example, mild to moderate migraine can be NSAIDs or paracetamol, otherwise triptan. Moderate severe migraine can be sumatriptan. And so you can see that this distillation, like when you're going back to a note, you really don't want to read paragraphs and paragraphs and paragraphs of stuff. And so being able to have that summary can be really helpful. And what you can even do to make this distillation even better is that you can actually add the distillation as a new property here. So I'm gonna create a new one called, maybe just call it distillation, literally. And then here, I'm gonna copy and paste this bit into here, like this. And so what happens is that if I go back to my second brain, look at it as a table, then immediately it's got the summary of what I need to know about migraines at that specific moment. And that's the distillation part of building a second brain. And finally, I might want to express this as something. In this particular case, I'm literally doing that right now, expressing it in this video, talking about how to build a second brain. But maybe you're expressing that in a presentation. Sometimes you can express this as a website. With Notion, there's actually a thing called super.so, which lets you make a website in Notion. For example, me and my friend, and this is not medicine related, but we created this website talking about YouTube. And this was all built in Notion. I'm going to be talking about that in a separate video about how to build that out. But basically, it uses super.so. And so you can check that out. But yeah, this is all built in Notion, which is really cool. So that's code all done in a nutshell. And that's the absolute bare basics of how to build a second brain. Now, para is an interesting concept. It's this idea that all your information should be organized in terms of actionability. So the P part of para is projects, and we've already displayed what projects are. They're basically these short-term things that you're working on right at this moment. And so that's the most basic way to organize your project. Areas are like long-term things. The idea behind areas is that you might want to have a place to collect a whole bunch of information. And so for example, migraines can actually be part of medicine as a whole thing. In fact, what I'm going to do is I'm going to keep this as migraine YouTube project, but I'm going to create a separate little categorization to put it as a area. And here that means that I can have projects and I can divide it by areas so that I can be like, oh, like I want to have all my medicine stuff, YouTube. And so now if I just wanted to look at one area at a time, for example, I just want to focus on medicine today, then certainly I can do that by clicking add filter, area, and medicine. And then we'll come up with this full table full of stuff there. Resources are maybe useful topics of interest. So for example, there's a guy I was interested in called Gwern, and he actually had done a whole bunch of stuff on generating anime faces in neural networks, which is super duper cool. So I might take his URL, it's not in medicine, so I'm gonna get rid of that, put it as a new one, and then put generating anime faces, and then literally just copy and paste that here. And then I'll put it in, because it's not a project yet that I'm interested in, so maybe I'll just put it in the general area of AI, and then I'm just gonna create a property here called type, and I'm going to name that resource. So basically, I'm gonna use this type as a way so I can actually get rid of it out of the way because I'm not actually actively working on it. So if I organize all of these really quickly in this montage, then that way I can help to you know, filter out stuff. I can get rid of the things that aren't resources and aren't areas so that I just have the stuff that I'm working on right now. And that's the bit that's come up in my second brain. There's a fair bit of overlap with archive because archive is really just, you wanna store it, but you don't want to do anything about it, right? So let's say that I've given up on the idea of doing anything about anime faces, but I still want to keep the note there. It's kind of similar to a resource, except you've decided that you're not going to do anything with it, and that's gone. So you don't want to deal with it again. So here, type is not archive, is the way that you're going to hide that from your second brain. The last thing I want to talk about to summarize building a second brain is this concept of progressive summarization. So let's go into our migraine thing again. Now this is already a very concise summary of what treatments are for migraine. You might want to choose to go even more concise and create a summary of a summary. So for example, like you literally just say paracetamol, NSAIDs, or triptans, and then that can be the thing that becomes your true distillation here. The idea behind progressive summarization is that you're really trying to just grab the stuff that's useful for you in your day-to-day life, because you may not actually have time to be able to search throughout your second brain. And if you wanted to look into it, you can actually dive deeper into it. Now, this is a very, very simple tutorial about second brain, but the reason I've left this tutorial so simple is because really it's as extensible as you want it. You know, you can create more tables, you can create headings, you can do whatever you want in Notion. Notion really lets you do anything and capture information in any way that you want. If you're not really sure about what to do, I've got a Skillshare course called Notion for Students and Professionals. You can check that out, and that talks about one sort of productivity system that you can use. Otherwise, I've got another video you can check out. It's called The Ultimate Notion Productivity System. But I still hope that you found this useful, even as just a very quick book summary of the building second brain ideas. Feel free to subscribe if you liked it, and I'll catch you in the next video.